So, some influencer says Apple lied to us about spatial video. It is just 3D video. Even I fell for that by mentioning it in my own video. I am wrong. To all the other haters on spatial video, you are wrong too. I did not just test the spatial video at Apple Store. I bought the $5,000 version and have been using it for more than 100 hours. I even flew across the country with it and did not even take it off for more than 5 hours straight. I am also a professional 2D cinematographer who has shot for Meta, Canon, Google, CBS News, and even ESPN. I know what I'm talking about. It looks different. It has parallax, and the immersive mode looks good. It is better than any 3D I have ever seen on any 3D TV or 3D devices. It is absolutely unfair to call it 3D because it is not. You can convert your 3D video into spatial video, which will look great inside the Vision Pro as well. Like what I'm doing here, shooting kimchi with the Canon R5C dual fisheye lens and Kendall Eagle. Any 3D camera can shoot spatial video if you are following my upcoming tutorial. But 3D video straight out of the camera is not spatial video, has no parallax, and the 2D just looks like 3D. Spatial video looks like real life in every sense, a capture of your memory. Now, let's directly screen capture what I see in 4K 30 frames per second from the Vision Pro. Most reviewers only know how to screen capture in 1080p with Foveated render on. But if you are an Apple developer and has Xcode installed with Reality Composer Pro, you can capture 4K 30 frames per second edge-to-edge sharpness. What the Vision Pro really see. Still, it is only one eye 4K monoscopic instead of 8K both eyes stereoscopic. So, you do kinda need to take my word for it on the 3D part of thing. Here is a 3D video play on Apple Vision Pro. It does not have that immersive mode button. When moving your head, it is not parallax. Also, the 3D looks 3D, a fake gimmicky look we all used to inside a 3D movie theater. Now, take a look at spatial video. By the way, this is the exact same source video captured with the Canon R5C with the dual fisheye lens in VR180. Instead of just dropping the 3D side-by-side video into Vision Pro like before, we first converted it into spatial video. Tutorial coming next. As you see in 4K 30 frames per second, it looks fantastic just like before. But more importantly, there is an immersive mode now that let you turn into that hazy memory look. If you move your head around, it is subtle, but it has a subtle parallax. It feels like you look behind the subject on the edges. We know we did not capture this in a volumetric capture, but it feels like it. It is a lot more natural to see 3D that way. Instead of looking like 3D, which has very defined edges and depth, it feels more like you are reliving the moment. Here it is in front of the Dante statue in Florence, Italy. You can see Kitty right here. It brought me back to that exact moment, that memory. It is a very subconscious feeling that you just have to try it yourself. It's not gimmicky 3D look for sure. Now let's talk about Foveated render, which is a huge deal and why this feature alone worth $3,000 for the Apple Vision Pro. Lots of other reviewers' screen capture look very blurry on the edges, including the original very negative review from The Verge. Great review by the way, but it is not really fair because the screen capture they use is affected by Foveated render. This means the edge are blurry because his eyes were not looking there. Apple Vision Pro is the only device besides Vario VR headset, which by the way costs a lot more than Vision Pro, has hardware level Foveated rendering. Basically, where you look render in full resolution, but around where you look will be low resolution render. As screen capture is usually wider than your actual field of view, the edges of all screen capture you see on the internet are blurry. This is not what you will experience inside the actual headset. So again, take all reviews on the internet with a grain of salt. The only real experience is to try it yourself physically. The benefit of Foveated render is to allow you to play 8K or even 12K immersive video or immersive game graphic in its full potential without any hardware limitation. This is key for immersive 180 and 360 video viewing. You can push the resolution limit beyond the hardware acceleration limit to achieve true-to-life graphic rendering. Right now, there isn't any games or immersive video are using the Foveated rendering, but when we figure out a way to play our own 12K 360 video inside Vision Pro, this will be an entirely different story. So, if you are new here and you want to nerd out on Vision Pro tech, don't forget to subscribe and give this video a big thumb up. Send this video to those haters who said Vision Pro Spatial video are just 3D video. Prove them wrong and stop that misinformation. We just tested all the 2D camera on the market and figured out a way to shoot better spatial video than the Vision Pro camera. Well, I wouldn't say better, but definitely different for sure. So if you are a creator who want to create on Vision Pro, don't want to miss the next one. Let's learn how to make some money back from your Vision Pro investment. See ya.